What's up, guys? My name's Josh, and this is HVAC Tech Tips, and today we're going to be reviewing the SMAN 480V manifold from Fieldpiece. I've got the box. It just came in, so let's start filming, and we'll do the unboxing. All right, so straight out of the box, here we go. This is how it's going to come from TrueTech. Functions and everything in a few minutes, but first we're just going to do the just unbox it and see what all it comes with. And we're also going to be comparing it to, I have the original, can't remember if it's 460 or 480, but this one's the 480V, so this one might have been the 480 without the V, not sure. Either way, we're going to be comparing the two. From what I understand, this one is much more durable and it's actually also water resistant. All right, let's get this thing unboxed. And of course, when it comes from Fieldpiece, it's always gonna have some nice packaging, nice bags. So let's get the foam out of it and let's see what we're dealing with. I'm digging that. All right, it don't take a lot to impress me these days. So we got our bag of goodies that comes with your batteries, six AA. Man, this thing's nice. I hadn't seen a new one in years and years and years. One of the major things that you notice right off the bat is it does not have the hookups for your clamps right in the front. Matter of fact, I'm gonna get my old one and we're gonna set it right beside it so we can truly compare the two as we're taking a look at all these new features on this one. So here's the two side by side, and you can look at the two faces and see that there are several new differences. We have our wireless capabilities. This all can hook up to your JobLink app, or it can also work with MeasureQuick. Well, yes, it will show just like, say, the your probes, the way it all pulls up onto the JobLink. This will do it also. You don't have to have the old school transmitter like you did with this one. This is where the clamps used to have to plug in. Right in the front, they get hit, they get bent, they're just really in the way there. So let's see where this, I believe the new ones, the new areas for these are the back. This is actually for a K-type temperature sensor that you can hook up for your outdoor temperature. And then with these, instead of it just plugging straight into the face, it's gonna go straight in, you push and it just slides straight in place. And then that rubber will keep it held in place. So that's how it looks, all plugged in. Very nice. So another feature that they have improved on is the sight glass. Supposed to be able to see your liquid much more clearly go through this port and through the sight glass than you did with this one, which I never could see very, very well in this one. But the biggest thing is the silver that's in the background of where your liquid is passing by, so it can contrast. This is all black and you can see it's silver all the way through. And I forgot to mention the K-top that you can hook up for your outdoor dry bulb. It actually comes with it just like most of your Fieldpiece stuff does, but this one, it's a little different. It's got a little alligator clamp on it. You can clamp it to the like the cage of the outdoor unit, and there's your outdoor temperature. Pretty neat. All right, so let's get these batteries in here and let's get this thing kicked on. I've got the batteries in it, the back's put on, but this one is all sealed up. The way these the clamps go in, if it's raining and you have this thing like it should be like this, water's not gonna get inside of that. So much more rugged and durable than it already was in the first place. So, all right, let's get it fired up. Most of y'all already know how regular SMAN works. So let's dive more into what all it can do now. What I would recommend doing is get you some of the wireless pop clamps. These work with the new SMAN. So we're going to try these out. And we're also going to try out psychrometers. And let's see how functionable all of this is together. So there's been several videos on how this would work with the wireless, but no one ever shows you how to actually do it. So let's see how easy it is to hook this up. So we're not going to be using these. We're going to try out all the wireless stuff with it and see how easy it is to hook up and how well it works. So we got our psychrometers are on right now, return and supply. So what you have to do is you have to go to menu, scroll through until you see wireless assign, enter. It automatically picks up your psychrometer and tells you the ID 5212. So let's see, 5212 is our return psychrometer. So then you'll hit enter. Now it wants to know the supply. Yes, enter. 5211, got it. Enter. When it gets to time to set up your clamps, it's gonna show top K, which is incorrect. You want to hit enter and then it'll start blinking like it has. Then you're gonna hit the down arrow until it gets to the different IDs. So this is 7511. 7511 is correct. So we are going to hit enter. Now liquid top K, this is where you'll get to see, you're gonna hit enter. Then it's gonna flash down, down, 7512. And that's that. So we'll hit enter. And we don't have a scale, which is pretty much the only other thing that's not hooked up to this that it can hook up to. Now we'll go back out of the menu. We're all hooked up. And I still gotta get my hoses real quick, put them on there. All right. So first things first, we're gonna go ahead and get these pop clamps put on. And these can be a little tricky. A lot of times I'll sand them before, but if they make a good connection after wiggling it with the rapid rail technology they have in there, it works really good. I've had it side by side with the K-top stuff, and just much more accurate, and it changes a lot quicker as well. So those things are, these are really the way to go, but the others work just fine too if you're just needing a really good, reliable set of gauges that's gonna give you a lot of information. All right, yes, don't judge me. I know I have a yellow hose over here on the suction line. I've been using my old S-Man like this for way too long and gotta get me some new hoses. But for the meantime, they're still hoses and they still work. So let's get all these hooked up. Got our clamps hooked up. Got our hoses hooked up. Let's see how it looks. Hit the button once, you get the blue screen display, which I've always loved with Fieldpiece. So for our outdoor, we're gonna use the new K-top it came with. Show you the back of it and where it's gonna go. Our outdoor is going to go right here in the middle, outdoor dry bulb. Now we're gonna just hook our right at the coil where it's pulling that air through, and we're gonna get that ambient temperature. I really like the clamp. Definitely much better than the Velcro. So now we got our dry bulb outdoor. And now we can scroll through and we'll be able to see our target, our target superheat. And then we can also keep scrolling and we'll be able to see our delta T, our wet and dry bulb temperatures from the psychrometers inside. So that's just showing our wet bulbs. Let's see, dew point, relative humidity. This is our delta T. So our delta T is 21.6, which it's pretty good. It may be, maybe a little high, so that probably means our evaporator could be a little dirty, or the filter, it could just be a filter deal. So We're not really doing a video to diagnose today. We're just wanting to check this thing out. So that's pretty cool. It calculates the load inside and gives you your target range of where it calculates your delta T should be. And then you get your actual down at the bottom after that. And then when you want to look and see what your target superheat is, you can just hit view. And there it is. Target superheat 7.4 is what it's calculating. And right now we're running at a 2.5. So this thing has a little bit of issues going on with it, but I'm actually just using this unit for this purpose of testing this thing out. So I really think this is really cool what Fieldpiece has done with this. I know this thing's been out a couple years, but I've just now got my hands on it and wanted to make a video. So now let's see. One thing I've been really interested in is how this is going to connect with the JobLink app. And let's see if it looks just the same, if it works just as easy as the probes that I use works. Okay, so we open up our Fieldpiece app. And nothing's going to be linked right now except for the psychrometers, since because they've already been done before. But you'll go down to the refrigerant and hit link tool. Then you'll see the SMAN pop up. Just click it, and it's going to load up everything else on its own. So everything is there for you. You just have to hit the symbol one time, the SMAN symbol, and you are all set and ready to go. And you shouldn't have to continue to do it unless you're switching back and forth from the probes to the SMAN setup, and then you'll just have to swap it over, but it's that simple. So yeah, all of this looks great, connected without any issues at all. All right, guys, so yeah, I'm officially sweating like a mofo on my day off, so I just can't get away from this heating and air stuff, right? I know that the S-Man is going to be another big improvement to how well I'm able to diagnose and the ease of being able to diagnose. It's well worth it, to be honest, really is. That's the end of the video. I hope y'all enjoyed it, and I hope y'all are excited about the new tool reviews coming up. And we're still going to be throwing in the service call videos as well. If you're new to the channel, please like and subscribe, and if you have subscribed, I really appreciate it. It means a lot, and we'll see you at the next video.